My mum never rings out a bingo, so she's made up.
Oh, what's she going to spend it on?
Well, it's a toss-up between having her hip done private or having a kitchen retailed.
Morning.
Hiya.
Oh, how did your blood test go?
Oh, yeah. Mum and baby tip-top according to the doc.
Hey. It's nice to have some good news.
Why, what's up?
Oh, Carla sacked Eileen yesterday.
You're kidding? What for?
For going to Leslie's funeral.
Eileen. You all right?
Well, I've been better. Then you only have to listen to the morning news to realise how lucky you are compared to some poor souls, eh?
Well, that's the spirit. Don't let the beggars grind you down, eh?
Oh, talking of which.
Can you not say something?
Nah, she's already sacked me twice. I might be thick-skinned, but even I'm starting to get the message.
Mrs. Connor, can we have a word? If it's about work, you can see me in your break. If it's not, I'm not interested. Can you not do something?
Sorry, Eileen, I tried.
Go on, you better go. I don't want you getting into trouble.
On my face and just tell them what I thought they wanted me to say, or, you know, just be honest.
So what worked best?
This is £1, please, thanks.
Oh, yeah, cheers, Emma.
Yes.
Thanks.
Thanks, Leanne.
See ya.
Hey.
Sorry, I can't stop. I've got a meeting with the CAFCAS officer.
Oh, right, well, I'm glad I've seen you then. Because I've been talking to my solicitor about this so-called bribe that you claim Carla had offered you.
She offered me money to abandon Simon. What else would you call it?
Well, same as any reasonable person would, like my solicitor said. It's an advance on the divorce settlement.
Really?
Yeah, really. But more to the point, she said if you start throwing these kind of accusations around, she might have to start digging up some of your less savoury episodes. You might appear to be the perfect mother now, Leanne. But everybody has a past.
I don't know if I can be bothered dressing up for this street party.
I'm toying with Cheryl Cole.
Really?
Massive hair, stupid shoes, too much makeup. Bob's your uncle.
Hey, we all could go as girls aloud. I could go as the one who's always getting bladdered.
I could be Kimberly.
Yeah, go on, back to Nicola.
Hi, Michelle. Do you fancy going as the Irish one from Girls Aloud?
Not really, no.
Oh, come on, spoil sport.
You're gonna make me love you. Nothing at all, nothing that I do. Promise I may, promise I may. Starting to fade, starting to fade.
What's going on here?
We were just having a little sing-song.
I don't want to hear it. We're one machine, it's down. So I suggest you put all your energies into your fingers, not into your lungs, all right? Or I should be following Eileen down to that job centre.
Flaming cheek. If she hadn't sacked Eileen, we wouldn't be behind at all.
Yes, well, I wouldn't push it if I were you. She's really not in the mood.
Can you gather that?
She can't just sack someone on a whim and expect everyone else to pick up the slack.
Why don't you point that out to her? See how you get on. Is that first lot gone, then?
We're just waiting on two more boxes.
What is this? Go slow.
Well, this is our dinner break, but we have gone as fast as we can, Mrs. Connor.
Well, that's not good enough.
I'm sorry, I just don't see how you can expect the same volume of work if you sacked a machinist. Of course the order's going to be behind.
Is there a problem in packing?
No.
Oh, good. And keep it shut, love. Leave the business to the grown-ups, eh?
Just pointing out the obvious.
Oh, I'm sorry. Is that what you were doing? Let me do the same, then. You see, my job is to run this place, and your job is to put these pants in this box. So let's stick to what we're best at, eh? Is that obvious enough for you?